Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 0, Leçon D. And we'll see together in this lesson le sujet. And we'll see actually in this video what in French can be subject of a sentence. Okay, le sujet, the subject. And basically it can be un nom, un pronom personnel, un pronom interrogatif, un pronom indéfini. Okay, so when we're talking about, when we're talking about a subject, it can be un nom, and it's a noun, un pronom personnel, and it's a subject pronoun, un pronom interrogatif, interrogative pronoun, or then un pronom indéfini, indefinite pronoun. And we'll see, and we'll of course start with the first one, un nom. Okay, so let's start with un nom. And I just wanted to have a simple sentence in that case. And it will be Vincent enseigne le français. Okay, so Vincent is a first name, and it's mine, by the way. Enseigne, here you've got a verb, so the verb is enseigner, and it's conjugated in that case, le français, so it's French, and we're referring to French language. Vincent enseigne le français. And in this sentence, you can see quite easily that Vincent here is the subject of the verb here. Okay, so we could also change this Vincent, take it away, and then put le professeur, and it means the teacher, and it will stay also the subject of the sentence, so it's connected directly to the verb enseigner here. Le sujet peut être un pronom personnel, so it can be also a subject pronoun as we saw. So let's see now how it would go. And in that case, same thing, simple sentence to start. Il visite Paris. Okay, so you get il here, I-L, visite. This is the verb visiter, you conjugate it. Il visite Paris. So in that case, you can see also quite easily that this is the subject of the sentence, and it's what we call un pronom personnel. So in English, it's more clear because it's subject pronoun, so no doubt about the function. And actually, we'll discover them together. So the first one is je, I, tu, you, il, he, elle, she. Okay, so je, tu, il, elle. And then for the plural form, we have nous, we, vous, you. So for the plural form, as in English, we tend to use it, well, of course, for the plural form, and also for the polite form, if you meet someone for the first time, it would be nice to use vous instead of tu. Il, they, so it's the masculine in that case, and then elle, they, but it's the feminine in that case. So in French, we make the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form when we use les pronoms personnels at the plural. Okay, so je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. All right. And so let's see now un pronom interrogatif. So same thing, simple structure, simple sentence, and the sentence is qui parle? So it's a question. Okay, so the verb is parler, parler is to talk, okay? And then when you put this qui, and qui is who, basically this qui becomes, of course, the subject in this sentence, and it's a question, who is talking? Qui parle? Qui parle? And the last one will be un pronom indéfini. And it's also quite useful, and I just wanted to make a simple sentence as well to make it clear. Same verb, parler is to talk, and then quelqu'un, someone or somebody. Okay, and in that case, quelqu'un parle, somebody is talking, someone is talking, and in that case, you can see quite easily that quelqu'un is the subject of the sentence.